Hello everybody and very good afternoon from Manipal Hospital, Dwarka. Today we are here to cater about the topic of 60 years and going strong. And I have Dr. Yashika Padesa, Dr. Gaurav Rastogi, and Dr. Apia from different specialties of OBGYN, orthopedics, and physiotherapy. As of now, I'll be introducing Dr. Yashika Padesa, who is the HOD of Obstetrics and Gynecology Department. Hello, ma'am.
Hello, Ms. Akshi.
Hi, ma'am. So over to you, and we shall just start with the presentation and enlighten the audience about how to take care of them after 60 years and be strong. Okay, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. So we are going to talk on a very upcoming topic, that is 60 years and going strong. As we know, the population here in India beyond 60 is increasing day by day. So we have to really take care of all the people who are above the 60 years of age. So there are a few aspects on which, from a doctor's point of view and especially a gynecologist's point of view, what all things you should take care of. So that is what I'll try to focus on. Next slide. So we all know prevention is better than cure. So the life, first of all, I'd like to tell you that life begins at 60. So the last 59 years have just been a practice. We all know that we have learned a lot, and now we have to start our life because we know everything about the life. But still there are some mistakes which we are doing, like many of the people above the age of 40 who should go for health checks are not going for health checks. So I would request yearly checkups after the age of 40 is required, and as your doctor's discretion, if she wants you to come a little early or wants you to get some investigations done every 3 years, like cervical cancer screening is to be done every 3 years, not to be done yearly. So your doctor will advise. We also know that we should all do walks, yoga, exercise to strengthen our bones, our muscles, and to get fresh air. So please continue doing who are doing, and who are not doing, please start it. Don't postpone it for tomorrow. Start it from today. Though we know that during COVID you are not able to do it, but still in many societies they have started allowing it. So you can take a walk with full precautions of mask and sanitization. Then you should take your medications. If somebody has diabetes, somebody has sugar, somebody has BP, somebody has cholesterol, so they should take their medicines in time. The problem which at the age of 60 people face is that they are not able to, they are forgetting the time of the medicine. They don't know how to maintain their charts and when to approach a doctor. First of all, you should, what my advice will be, you should have some boxes kept ready. If there are some young people at home, they should help their elderly. They should make some boxes for morning, evening and night and put the medicines there so that they take it in time. They should not delay their medicines, because somebody who's hypertensive, if they miss their medicine, they can have a high BP. So the same way, and somebody at house who is there, even the grandchildren, remind their grandparents if they are forgetful. Your medicine is due, especially people who are on insulin, their medications should not be missed. They should take good sleep. This actually is a little funny to say, because most of the people in old age start sleeping very less, or they have a little problem in initiation of sleep, or maybe they have lots of interruptions in their sleep because of urination, because of stress, or because of many other reasons. With age, usually the sleep pattern disrupts and the sleep requirement also decreases a lot. But if you have a healthy abdomen, healthy bowel system, and you are exercising, and you do, then there is no problem in sleep. So first of all, you should have a good bowel movement, and your sleep is not disrupted. And tire yourself a little bit, do some type of exercise, then you will have a good sleep. Healthy diet, we all know what is healthy diet and what we should eat, fruits, everything. Carbohydrates should be decreased, proteins should be increased our diet. Proteins is important for everyone, young children, pregnant ladies and the elderly. So these three age groups, they should always take a lot of proteins in their diet. So please do it so that you will not get sick. We are talking about prevention here. So please start taking the proteins. Any disease you have, if you have not taken care of it, for you know that you have a little heart problem, or you have some problem in your leg, in your knees, you have maybe a little bit of osteoarthritis, but you are still not going to the doctor because you are scared. If you will go, that she will detect some other disease with you. So please don't do that. Get yourself treated, because once the disease spreads a lot and damages the organs, then that the treatment becomes little complicated. So if treated early, you can get treatment with exercise also, you can get cured with minimal medications, you can get. If somebody has some sexual dysfunction at this age, usually patients suffer from some or the other, they can always approach the doctor. People are usually very ashamed of talking about such things. Sometimes the female partner is not interested, sometimes the male partner is not interested. But if both the partners have a little bit of interest, they should talk to their doctor and solve those problems. They should, if somebody is drinking, smoking and some addiction they have, they should decrease it. So because it's not the age when you should be continuing with those addictions. And my request to most of the people, because I have parents who don't have insurance, so I would tell all my elderly people and their children, if they have insurance in their offices, they should take insurance for their parents. I have taken my insurance for my parents also. So take health insurance as early as possible. Children who are young and joint jobs, they should ask their parents to take insurance, give their parents insurance so that whenever they are sick in future, they don't have lots of problems. Why we need to take care at 60? Why are we talking about this topic right now? Why was it not needed earlier? Because we all know the quality of life has improved so much. Though we talk about a lot of pollution and we talk about so many diseases coming up, but we still know the quality of life. The life expectancy in our country has increased. We have seen our grandparents and many other people elderly there. They used to die at 40 and 50, but now, right now, even at 60 and 80, they are still there with us and we are taking good care of them and they're healthy. And we expect them to stay with us for a long time. So because of the expectancy increasing, we take care of our elderly and we should take care of our health. It's not that after 40, 50 or 60, we are bedridden. We should at least have that much of capacity to take care of ourselves very well. So, and we want, and everybody who's elderly, whose children are out of India or who are children are settled somewhere else, they're staying alone, they have to take care of all the needs of the family, the marketing, the shopping, the home needs, and all the care, everything has to be done by this couple only. So they have to be healthy and active. If they are not, how will they manage? So if one partner is sick, at least the other partner should be healthy so that they can take care. So they should prevent the falls, they should take care of their partner, be updated to the technology. This is also a very important thing which I want all elderly to know, because if I have faced this problem, like my parents, they never wanted to change their phone, they never wanted to upgrade their phones, but nowadays, you know, everything is there. You have online banking, going to the bank at times can be difficult for elderly. So these things are very safe if you have learned them properly. So learn from your children, and children who are listening to it should teach their children, parents, so that they don't have this problem. And old elderly should be very enthusiastic to learn it. They should not say that think that it is a burden. So this is a chart which is just to show you how after the 40 age, you see how our bones start deteriorating. In this slide, you can see there is rapid loss. Menopause, after menopause, and this slide is showing before menopause also we have this chart with us. So this is showing that even before menopause, after the age of 40, our bones start deteriorating a little bit, and after 40 it is a sharp decline. And so we should take care, and after menopause especially it is a very sharp decline. So please take care of your bones. After the age of 40, perimenopausal also, so people start suffering few problems like mood swings, cramps, weight gain, nausea, irritability. So you should meet your doctor and talk to her. And some, yesterday only I met a patient who was almost a case of premature menopause, but she has been treated for a long time, last 2-3 years, taking some medications, having her periods, and then again going back to no periods. But nobody had yet investigated her and confirmed her diagnosis. Because if somebody has a post-premature menopause, they should get treated. Otherwise, what will happen? Premature menopause is having menopause at a very early age, that is less than 40. So what will happen? Her bones will start getting weaker before that age. So what you should do is you should meet your doctor and take hormonal therapy. You should not avoid it. Hormonal therapy is for your good and not for your bad. It might be bad for some patients, that your doctor will decide whether you should not take hormonal therapy or you should take, because there are lots of benefits with hormonal therapy. Then after the age of 45, when you are about to menopause, the time is coming near, when you are about to finish with your periods, that is the time that hot flushes start coming. People usually complain that there are a lot of sweating and they feel very heated up, especially in the night time, and then they get up, the whole body is full with sweat. So this is a sign that you're having hot flushes. They might have tachycardia, ghabrahat, and don't feel like eating anything. So those things do happen, and there is treatment for that. Few people have dryness, and then after the age of 55-60, which we are talking, is the osteoporosis stage which comes. So, and because the osteoclastic activity starts, because Dr. Gaurav and Afia will be taking care of the bone part, so I will not be talking in detail about that. So I just wanted to show you all these picture. You can see this first picture of the diet. So this is what you have to take after the age of 40. All females, especially males, also have to take a lot of care of their bone health. But especially the females, they should take at least 4 to 5, 6 servings of milk products. But it is not possible. So at least 2 glasses of milk, 2 katoris of curd. You, and every day you cannot take. You can take lassi, you can take cheese, you can take paneer. You can take chia seeds and lots of broccoli, and all those, these have folic acid, mushrooms, and then you have almonds. So please, and those who are non-vegetarian, they should take fishes because it has omega-3. People who are vegetarian, they should take super added omega-3, and some DHA products which are vegetarian are also come out in the market. Vitamin D is very important because bone health cannot be prevented just with calcium. We need vitamin D and phosphates also for that. So if required, you should be given, and your doctor will also prescribe. Magnesium is also deficient in most of our patients. Multivitamin is deficient in most of our patients. And the care of this, you can see this picture of how the bones start becoming porous. Porous is like a sponge. So how dense the bone was, the calcium starts deteriorating and becomes porous. So what will happen if you have porous bone? Nothing will happen. You will fall, you will have a fracture. And otherwise, if you fall, what will happen? You will not have a fracture. You might just have a pain for some time and you will be okay. But if you have a very porous bone, especially females, they have lots of hip fractures and wrist fractures, which is the most, in the more maximum area where the bone density weakens. And then the skin, everybody is working, everybody is going to the office, everybody wants to look young. So skin care is also very important in the postmenopausal age group, after the age of 60. So the treatment modalities, hormone replacement therapy, only after discussing with your doctor, getting yourself investigated. Then we have management of urinary and rectal incontinence. If you talk about urinary and rectal incontinence in India, so it's the most underrated disease. None of my patients will come to me with, I will not say none, few of them, very few of them will come with this problem, ki ma'am, I have my urine leaks out or my motion leaks out. But this is so common in most of our patients. If I ask them a direct question, do you have this problem? They say, yes, they have this problem. People stop being sexually active. People stop going to social meetings, gatherings, because they are ashamed that they may have a urinary leak. They may have a rectal incontinence. They might have a lot of gas passing, which will be uncomfortable, but they never talk to their doctor. And there are so many, even in physiotherapy with Kegels and lots of other methods, even in yoga, Kapalbharati and many other diseases, you can just cure a large part of urinary and rectal incontinence. Every person is not there needing a surgery. Only a very small group will need a surgery. So you should go to your doctor. There might be some people have constipation. So that is also leading to rectal incontinence and the passing of lot of gas. And because of that pressure, the vaginal area and the urinary area is prolapsing. So if we solve that problem also, a lot of it improves. Because as we said, as the we start aging after 60, our muscle mass decreases because of less of protein in there. We are not exercising. And the muscles of the pelvic area also start losing their strength. So if we keep on exercising in that area, like we exercise for our body parts, but we are not exercising in that. There might be a lady who is going to the gym regularly, she's exercising all of her body parts, but maybe she's not exercising her muscles of the pelvic area. So she might have urinary incontinence when she's lifting weights. So we have to teach her that you should do this, and that will treat her. So the pelvic floor dysfunction is there. Then we have cancer prevention and treatments for cervical, breast, ovarian and uterine. This is, I'm talking about the female part. In male, we have prostate cancer, which is there at the later age, which is also has to be taken care. Though lung cancer mostly stays a very common cancer in the females also, but cervical, breast, ovarian and uterine needs to be treated. Breast and cervical, they have screening methods. We can prevent ourselves from these two diseases. Ovarian and uterine, I don't have a screening method. Uterine, usually patients present with some or the other bleeding irregularity. In ovarian, which is can be silent. But lot of ovarian screening tests, diagnosis and technology advancements are taking place. Maybe in future we will have something. But still now there is nothing, no diagnostic test for ovarian cancer. Then we have palliative care for people who are actually very sick and cannot be given any surgical modality. So at home therapy, just pain management therapy is there for them. Osteoarthritis, we know lots of our old elderly people have knee joint problems. They're not able to walk properly. With physiotherapy, with exercise, at least they can walk. Maybe they will not be running, but they will be walking. So please treat it at the earliest. We have osteoporosis, osteopenia. So bone densitometry needs to be done to know whether our bones are really very weak. Because after the age of 60, Dr. Gaurav will, I think, enlighten you on that, phosphates decreases. So patients should be very sure about that they are taking phosphates and they are given phosphates by their doctors. And some patients might need injectable also. Some patients might not need injectable. So that has to be decided depending on your bone density and your levels. And there are few patients I have come across, they have been taking phosphates for a very long time without stopping. And in that case, the bones become brittle and if they fall, they will have a fracture. So please, on your own, don't take. Many patients come to us, we should not take calcium, that will cause stone. But they are not, they are taking phosphate, they are taking other things and they don't know what they should do. But they are afraid of calcium. What I feel is calcium tablets, usually you take one tablet. It is not even always 1000 milligrams. So even if you are taking one calcium tablet of 500 milligrams, it is not going to cause stones in your body. So please, I think this is a myth that people think that if your doctor has specifically advised you, your urologist, not to take it, then you stop taking it. Otherwise, I think none of these patients should worry about the stone. In the age of, after the age of 60, the mental health also is very important. People might start having dementia, Alzheimer's. These are the diseases in which people are going for walks. I am also very scared at times that my father might go for a walk and he might forget his way. But right now he's healthy, so I'm not worried. But there might be coming a time that this might happen. So if we treat it at the earliest, we do exercises and we meet a neurologist and take medications and multivitamins. So this can be delayed. Maybe we cannot totally remove it from our life, but it might happen not at 60, maybe at 80. But if it happens at 60, we can try to avoid it by taking medication in time. Then cosmetic care, as we talked about, that's required. Some people, some females always want to look good. Some males also want to look good, so they should always go for cosmetic care. What is the major causes of death in this age group? Heart disease is the most important. Because in female, till they have not attained the menopause, their heart is the most healthy and healthier than the males. But as soon as they menopause, their heart function starts decreasing. And they should really take care, good care of their heart. And they should have regular checkups. And many females have little bit arrhythmias, which might need treatment because ghabrahat and missed beats are very common in them. So meet a cardiologist and scan whether you don't have any other superadded disease. Then we have cancers, which is very common cause of death. Cancer is a cause of death only when not detected in time. That is what I believe. So please don't, most of my patients say, I don't want to go to the doctor because something or else will come because they will write a test and I'll do a test and some disease will come. But they are not forgetting it, that if the disease is detected late, then treatment modality will be difficult. Then the other thing is stroke. Then we have COPD. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, lots of people have pulmonary diseases. Though in females, the disease will be a little less because they are less smoking, but lots of females are smoking these days. We never know when they are 60, they might have these diseases, but at present, males are more prone to these diseases. Then we have pneumonia, influenza, diabetes, and lots of patients die because of accidents also. Like I will say, even the hip fracture can cause the death of a patient because of fat embolism, lot of blood loss, and septicemia if not treated, because at this age many times the patients, the old people are not very receptive to any directions what the children say, the doctors say. They are very adamant to what they want. So they should, I think, listen, because the technology has advanced so much. They should listen to their children, listen to the doctors, and let them treat them. we'll just talk a little bit of the male partner, because I think Dr. Charu is not there with us, who would have highlighted a little more on the problems in the males. I will say that prostate care is very important in males, and the rest of the problems are almost similar as in males or in females after the age of 60. And all medical complications should be treated. They should also exercise and walk. And psychological health is very important, and sexual health also is very important for the male partner. So checkups and care. So eye checkup, hearing checkup, dementia and depression, they should also be checked if we have a suspicion that we are very forgetful. It's very common to forget in old age when we have lots of work to do, or because of old age, little bit of dementia can be normal, but if it's increasing and needs treatment, you should meet the doctor. And nutrition, you should be very careful. If you still have doubts, always meet a dietitian, or go to blogs, go to internet, go to Facebook, ask somebody, dietitian in your home, ki what is best for you. Treat your vitamin deficiencies, calcium deficiencies, vitamin D deficiencies, take multivitamins, proteins, isoflavones is very important. Isoflavones are natural estrogen. So all my females, I usually tell them to take, we have calciums with isoflavones, which I prefer to give to my patients, because then they don't have to take it separately also at times, because people usually don't take. And we have this myth of not taking soya bean in our country. Everybody say, most of the people are hypothyroid. They say, if you are treated, a little bit of soya bean in your diet or twice or thrice in a week will not cause you any problem. So soya bean is the richest source of protein in a vegetarian diet. And most of our people are avoiding it. So I would suggest, and I would prefer all of you to take a little, we have soya milk, we have soya badi, we have soya dal, we have there, and we have tofu with us. So many sources of soya are there. You can always take them and increase the natural estrogen in your body, and phosphates. And vaccination, please, all of you, please take vaccination for all the diseases which I have mentioned, pneumococcal, influenza, Boostrix, hepatitis A, typhoid, hepatitis B. So pneumococcal, influenza, and Boostrix, if taken, will prevent you from a lot of diseases if you get sick, and if you are, will be prevented, lung infections will be prevented. And footwear is very important for our old age. Footwear and foot care. Podiatry is increasing a lot in our country. Maybe in time it will have another department with us. You should have a very good footwear. You should not, footwear ka main, main thing which we have to focus on footwear is they should not fall. Falling leads to fractures and lots of problems in elderly. So please be very careful. Talk to your doctor if you don't have an idea. And all medications should be taken in time, as I said, and they should take the help of the family members if they think they are forgetting the medicines. Thanks, everyone. So we will take the questions after Dr. Gaurav and Afia has completed the talk. So I'd like to invite Dr. Gaurav. He's the consultant in orthopedics at Manipal Hospital, and he will be of all our female patients after the age of 60 and the male patients. So because in males, I don't think they have a lot of problem. It's only the females who would have to take a lot of care of their bone health.
Hi everybody. First and foremost, I should thank Dr. Yashika Gudesir for such a nice introduction. For me, I'm Dr. Gaurav Sogi. I'm an orthopedic surgeon working in Manipal Hospital's Varkam. And why this talk is important? Because the most common problems people more than 60 years old have are musculoskeletal, that is the bone and joint pains. Right? That is the most common reason why people more than 60 years old enter or visit the hospital. So coming to bone health, now bone health is really important. Reason being, fracture is something which are responsible for a lot of morbidity. Now that is rather the number one cause of morbidity amongst people who are more than 60 years old. Now the current definition is changing. We no longer call people more than 60 years old as elderly, right? We simply call them as more mature, right? Now bone health has six components. in people who are more than 60 years old. Number one is exercise, which is the most important thing, which all of you have to do. Now, I will elaborate further what kind of exercise you need to do, and further details would be discussed by our senior physiotherapist, Dr. Afia. Second, we are going to talk about osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is, I am pretty sure that's not a new word for you. It simply means soft bones, and it is inevitable. It happens with everybody. Now, third thing, which is very commonly asked to me in my clinics, is nutrition. What should I eat? What should I not eat? Then vitamins. Vitamins were one of the most ignored topics recently, but over the past 10 years, their prominence has increased, and now everybody is well versed in vitamins, especially vitamin D. Fall prevention is something which Dr. Yashika has already talked about, and also Dr. Afia will be having a word about it. And the last, and actually the most important, is think strong, right? A sound body, for a sound body, a sound mind is important, right? If you are thinking strong, nothing will happen to you, right? And I'll also elaborate on why thinking strong is important. So coming to exercises, now all the people more than 60 year old, both men and women, they need to do moderate level exercises. Now the question is that how do I know whether the exercise I'm doing is a moderate level exercise or just severe intense exercise? Now the simple dictum is that if you can talk while doing the exercise, then you are performing moderate level exercise, like simply walking, right? You simply walk for say 20 minutes in a day, right? While walking, you can easily have conversation. Now that's a moderate level exercise for you. Group exercises are better for elderly, for people more than 6 year old. The reason being is that you do have interpersonal communication, a lot of coordination when you're doing group exercises. Plus you, honestly speaking, you enjoy doing those exercises. Now amongst exercise, what is important is that you should do 150 minutes of exercise in a week. Now roughly that translates to 15 to 20 minutes of exercise in a day, which is actually not much considering the fact that you have 24 hours in a day. One thing which you have to avoid is you have to avoid impact exercises. Now it's no point you going for a run, right? The moment you hit a treadmill, you will surely visit me or one of my orthopedic colleagues because you will end up having knee pain. So just avoid impact exercises. What is more important for you is stretching. Now the Western world has realized the importance of stretching. So we have yoga out there. We also have yoga here. We are celebrating yoga days. So yes, you have to stretch, right? Stretch your body, that's important. Further details about it will be discussed by Dr. Afia. Nutrition, why is nutrition important? Because it's commonly seen that people who are overweight, they have pain in the joints, they have pain in the back. So yes, you have to maintain their ideal weight, which is easier said than done, right? What is important is balanced diet. So a diet which is rich in proteins, rich in carbohydrates, rich in fat, plus it also has essential minerals and essential vitamins. So a simple Indian diet of having roti and dal is actually a balanced diet, plus salad, of course. Right, fruits, eat a lot of fruits. Now fruits are easy to digest, they have the vitamins, they have the minerals. Right, also fructose is much well tolerated by the body as compared to sucrose. Now fructose is a fruit sugar, whereas sucrose is a normal sugar which we eat. Now as we grow old, our body is more comfortable with smaller meals, but on a more frequent basis. So that instead of eating twice or thrice in a day, we can eat 4 times or 5 times in a day. Only thing is the portions should be smaller. So instead of eating 3 chapatis, right, you should be comfortable eating 1 chapati, but you have to eat it around 4 to 5 times in a day. Now avoid binge eating. So all those barbecue nation type buffets, right, that is something which you have to avoid, right? You have a buffet and then you will definitely have some stomach upset and you will be visiting a doctor. So that is something which you have to avoid. Now vitamins, most of the vitamins, that is the vitamin B complex, vitamin A, vitamin E, are derived from balanced diet, hence the importance of balanced diet. However, there are two vitamins which are notoriously not derived from diet, and they are vitamin D and vitamin B12. And believe me, vitamin D deficiency is way more. So it's, some studies say that 60 to 70% normal population is deficient in vitamin D. Now if you just look at the numbers, right, 1.3 billion strong country, 50% of that, whoa, that's a whopping number. Now that's, vitamin D is again important because that is crucial for bone health. Normally we require 1000 units a day. That's a daily requirement. So irrespective of your men, your women, right, you need 1000 units a day. the main source of vitamin D, unfortunately, is sunlight, right? And I am pretty sure that not us, or many of us, are spending 20-30 minutes in a day in sunlight with our neck, whole arms, and the knee exposed. Right? If you're doing that, then you're having your daily requirement of vitamin D. And so that is actually encouraged. Now, what is very important, which Dr. Yashik also mentioned, is annual checkup. Right? These are really important. In annual checkup, your vitamin D and vitamin B12 should also be assessed. Now, if they are low, then you need to be put on supplements. Right? Now, coming to vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is predominantly derived from non-vegetarian diet. In a country like ours, where 60% of the population is vegetarian, vitamin B12 deficiency is not far from reality. It is quite commonly seen. And if that is less, then supplementation helps. Dr. Afia would be mentioning in her talk that vitamin B12 is also required for balance. So if you are low in vitamin B12, then your balance would go haywire and you become more susceptible to falls. Now, osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is inevitable. Everybody will have osteoporosis, right? For that, you have to understand what happens with our bone density. Now, when we are born, right, from that time till the time we become 30 to 35 years old, the bone density increases gradually, and then it plateaus and then starts declining after the age of 35 years. We cannot stop the decline, but we can do control the rate of decline. So instead of declining like this, it will decline slowly like this. How do we decrease the rate of decline? Exercise, right? So that is the importance of exercise, moderate level exercise. That's like an investment, right? And your 20 minutes a day is an investment to keep your bones strong and to prevent you from fracture. Now, in women, especially, menopause contributes to osteoporosis, which has been very nicely elaborated by Dr. Yashika. Animal health checkups are important for osteoporosis. So in animal health checkup, do include bone densitometry assessment, that is DEXA. In case your bone density is less than minus 2.5, that means you are osteoporotic. That means you are higher risk of having a fracture in case you fall, or even in case you trip on a loose piece like carpet. Right? In that case, you have to be on supplements, which your doctor would prescribe you. Now, fall prevention. Now, why are we talking about fall prevention? Again, because fractures are the number one cause of morbidity in this country. Majority of fractures can be prevented. Not everybody have their bones broken in an accident, right? So believe me, domestic falls, that is falls in your bathroom, fall from stairs, is way more common than accidents, and they are very common cause of fractures. So simple things like preventing loose items in the house, like loose carpets, furniture which has been just put haywire. In case you have kids in your family, then they normally put toys at random places, your grandsons or granddaughters, and then you might trip on that and you might fall. So you have to instruct your house helpers, or you have to instruct your sons and daughters to take care of that. Eyesight is really important. If you are having refractory errors, if you're not able to see, then you are at higher risk of falling. Again, medicines, certain medicines like for BP, for blood pressure, etc., that can cause dizziness and something called as orthostatic hypotension. And the moment you stand, you feel dizzy. So you have to, in case this is happening to you, then kindly contact your physician. They might need to alter those medicines. You have to check your hearing also, because hearing problems are commonly associated with balance problems. Our inner ear not only helps in hearing, it is also the balance center of our body. Now, quickly talking about miscellaneous things, the do's and don'ts especially. Now, knee is the most common joint affected in aging. Knee osteoarthritis is rather the most common geriatric problem noted. It is even more common than refractory errors. Now, everybody will have problems in the knee as they age. Now, a common question people ask is, which is better, Indian commode or Western commode? Now, for knee specifically, you have to avoid squatting. So you have to avoid going all the way down. So Western commode is better. Also, stairs is something which you have to be careful of, right? You have to avoid climbing stairs on a fast basis. You have to climb it on a step-by-step basis, right? And again, a very commonly asked question, not related to this, is if knee replacement is required, then when should I get a knee replacement done? Now, the answer is that if you're not able to walk 400 yards, if you're not able to perform your activities of daily living, like changing clothes, wearing socks, taking out socks, and if you are not on daily painkillers, if the pain is bearable and you need not take any painkiller, right, on a frequent basis, then probably you can avoid getting a knee replaced. Now, shoulder, diabetes is the number one enemy of shoulder. So if you're diabetic, you have to stretch your shoulder, otherwise your shoulder will become stiff. You have to take care whether your diabetes is controlled or not. In case your diabetes goes haywire, then the number one indication is your shoulder starts hurting, right? So conversely, if you are diabetic and your shoulder starts hurting, then you also have to visit your diabetologist or endocrinologist to see whether your sugars are normal or not. Now, again, a very common cause of pain in elderly population is protractor shoulders. These are shoulders which come forward. Now, that is predominantly positional. When you are working on laptop or we are writing something, our shoulders, they have a tendency to come forward. We have to voluntarily retract it, right? That is very important. You have to bring it back, okay? So that's some exercise which you have to do. You have to ensure that your position is not going wrong. In case you're bending forward, right, then probably you will end up compressing your spine. So you need to have a proper position. That is very important. Foot. Now, footwears, people ask which footwear is good for me. Should I wear flat? Should I wear heels? Should I wear closed footwear? Should I wear open footwear? But the answer is open footwear is better than closed footwear because it avoids problems associated with sweat. The footwear should not have a narrow box. Now, narrow box means that it should not be narrow, pointed, because otherwise it will crumble upon your toes and you might end up having deformity of your great toe, which you would have seen called as bunion and hallux valgus. Right, sports shoes should always be preferred. So whenever you're going for your morning walk, please wear sports shoes. You can easily purchase them. If you need to wear heels, right, if there's a marriage in the house, then of course you cannot attend it in sports shoes. We understand that, especially for all the women out there. Then you have to wear platform heels, right? You should avoid stilettos. You have more chance of having imbalance on it. You have more chance of falling. And if you fall, you come to me. Now, thinking strong is important because it says that you are old only when you think that you are old. So if you are young in your mind, right, then you will not age, right? Well, that is not an elixir for youth, but thinking strong is very important. Think that you're a young person, think that you can do what you can do. Now, happy mind releases endorphins and that helps you. If you are under stress, some kind of stress, then your muscles, especially the muscles in the back of the neck, muscles in the lower back, they become tight. And that is a very common cause of pain in the neck and the back. Meditate, that helps, really helps, right? One more thing is keep yourself active as much as possible. Try to do your household chores yourself. Right, try to do the cleaning and the dusting. The more you do it, the better it is. Right, you should cook food for yourself. Just do not be a lazy person sitting on a couch thinking that I'm old and everybody will help me. Right, the day you think like that, the day you become old and the day you invite problems. So with that thing, I'll thank everybody for watching this webinar. I hope I was able to convey what I wanted to convey. Now, next in line is Dr. Afia. She's a senior physiotherapist and she will be elaborating more on what I was telling. And she'll tell you fantastically what aging is. Bye.
Hello everyone. Thank you, Gaurav sir and Dr. Yashika, for like enlightening us about the topic 60 years and going strong. First of all, I would like to wish every senior citizen, because today is the Senior Citizen Day and we are enlightening you with the, all these 60 years and going strong. And according to me, aging is not at all a disease. It's a natural condition that need to be nurtured and advanced. So basically I'll be talking about the physiological, the main common problems and what all preventions we can take, because we don't have one-to-one solution for all. We just give you a prevention tips, we can give you some like exercises, we can tell you some like what all changes you can make at home, but every person is unique, so they need, if they like for any problem they need a proper tailor-made exercise protocol. If they have like prior Parkinson's disease, any neurological, any musculoskeletal disease, we just brief you about like problems and the solution, but not only the solution. Okay, so basically let's talk about like what are the normal physiological aging physiology in of aging. So first, body composition. There is all gradual loss of lean mass. Usually hum log ne dekha hai bade logo ki jhuriyan aa jati hain, matlab haath latakne lag jate hain, to basically muscle mass loss hota hai. So everything, ek baat hamesha yaad rakhiyega, body ka koi bhi ek cheez, koi bhi ek part दूसरे से ऑलमोस्ट कनेक्ट रहता है. एक प्रॉब्लम होगी तो दूसरे से कनेक्टेड रहेगी. सो यू नीड टू स्क्रीन, आपको अपने आप पे ध्यान देना है कि कहाँ क्या चीज लॉस हुई, क्या प्रॉब्लम आ रही है, देन वी गो. सो इंक्रीज बॉडी कॉम्पोजिशन में हमारा मसल मास एक तरह से लॉस हुआ, देन इंक्रीज इन फैट हुआ, देन बोन मिनरल लॉस. एज डॉक्टर गौरव हैज ऑल्सो टोल्ड यू कि बोन मिनरल्स, इसके अंदर रिजॉर्प्शन हमारी और फॉर्मेशन, इन दोनों के बीच में एक इम्बैलेंस हो जाता है विद एजिंग, बिकॉज इट्स अ नेचुरल लाइक फिजियोलॉजी इन आर बॉडी. सो यूजली हमारी बोन ऑस्टियोपोरोटिक हो जाती है एंड धीरे धीरे, इसीलिए अबव 60 अबव हम बोलते हैं कि बहुत ज्यादा चांसेस होते हैं फ्रैक्चर्स के. सो दिस इज द मेन रीजन दैट वी लॉस्ट आवर बोन मिनरल्स. देन वी आर आल्सो हैविंग मोर फॉल्स बिकॉज ऑफ आवर पोस्टरल चेंजेस, आवर गेट चेंजेस. यूजुअली व्हाट हैपन लाइक इन ओल्ड एज और यूजुअली अबव लाइक 60 इयर्स ओल्ड, our head thrust increase. Head thrust in the sense we start developing this kind of posture. We want to sit like this. Even if the old people want to hear you, he just move his hands towards you. Then with this, there is an extension because normally we have this curvature of our cervical spine. Due to this posture, our head spine gets started extending, matlab like straightening of the spine. And with this, we have like बहुत सारे लोग थे पीछे इसका ये कमर उठ रही है हम लोगों की. With aging, हम चलने के time our posture, usually we develop this kind of posture, stoop posture usually. So we have accentuated thoracic kyphosis. Then in response to that, we have a like impact on the lower spine, that is the straightening of spine. And then we, मतलब usually old age people develop the low back pain, chronic में वो खत्म नहीं होता क्योंकि एक चीज एक दूसरे से connected है. And usually जब भी आप जाते हैं गर्म सिकाई में नहीं हाँ कर ली, लेकिन problem शायद ऊपर वाली spine से शुरू हुई है, वो हमें पता नहीं होता. Then we have a scapular protraction and ulnar deviation of hand, and ultimately all these postural leads to our jo central of gravity hoti hai uske andar shift kar deti hai and it leads to normally falls. Usually aapne dekha hoga bathroom slips common hai just because ki wo ekdam sudden posture change hota hai, adapt nahi kar pata COG base of support and then they have a fall or trips. We have a skin changes also, like moisture content reduce hota hai, epidermal renewal reduce ho jata hai, elasticity reduce ho jati hai, or sensitivity to touch, pain and temperature, and even the vibratory sense of the old age people reduces. So hence they are more susceptible to injuries, kyunki bahut bahut sare time unko feel nahi hota. Usually aap dekhoge diabetic to hamare India mein bahut zyada common hai, unko hum log isliye kehte hain ki foot care, hamesha joota ek thoda sa size bada le. Kyun? Kyunki us time pe unke ye sari jo touch aur pain, in sab ki sensitivity kam ho jati hai and it leads to like kuch kuch matlab problems ho jate hain, kuch kahin kahin scars ho jate hain jo unhe pata hi nahi chalta hai. डायबिटिक में स्कार का जैसे ठीक होना काफी टाइम लगाता है, तो इसलिए यू नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ योर एवरी बॉडी पार्ट. और टेंशन लेके नहीं करना कि यार ये देखना है वो देखना है क्या देखें, अगर आप दिन में भी एक एक चीज का ध्यान रखेंगे धीरे धीरे तो सारी चीजें एक लाइन में आती रहेंगी. छोटी छोटी चीजों का ध्यान रखें, बड़ी चीजें अपने आप जगह पे आ जाएंगी. उसके साथ जो गेट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, यूजुअली वुमेन्स जो है ना उनके पेल्विक का एरिया बड़ा होने की वजह से वेल्डिंग टाइप ऑफ गेट में चलती है, मतलब लाइक ऐसे जैसे एक टाइप चलते हैं ना वो यूजुअली वेल्डिंग गेट की तरह चलते हैं, और उनका जो बेस ऑफ सपोर्ट होता है ना वो नैरो हो जाता है क्योंकि वो बाहर थोड़े से पैर ऐसे टेढ़े रख के चलते हैं, और इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट जो मैन है उनका क्या होता है छोटे स्टेप लेते हैं और उसी के साथ साथ जो है बेस जो होती है उनकी वाइडर हो जाती है। सो जब भी आप वॉक करें या आपके इस घर में पेरेंट्स हैं या ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, आप उनको वॉक पे लेके जाएं, आप लोगों को बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है उनको ऑडिटरी क्लू दें, लाइक आप दादा दादी या मम्मी पापा आप सही चलें, सीधा चलें, थोड़ा सा उनका स्टेप्स बनाएं, चाहे रोज ज्यादा नहीं चलवाएं, बिल्कुल 5 मिनट्स अगर वॉक कर रहे हैं तो दे शुड वॉक इन अ प्रॉपर मैनर, उनके हाथ भी स्विंग्स हो रहे हैं, अगर वो वॉकिंग एड ले रहे हैं तो उसमें भी ये है कि वॉकिंग एड और अपोजिट जो है वो एक साथ रखें, एंड देन धीरे धीरे वो मतलब डायगोनल पैटर्न चलता रहे उसके साथ साथ। इसमें स्विंग फेस डिक्रीज हो जाता है, दैट मींस कि एरिया कि हमारा लेग जो है वो डिक्रीज हो जाता है, और डबल जो पीरियड सपोर्ट का टाइम होता है वो बहुत बढ़ जाता है। सो जब ये हमारी बॉडी की, फिर इसलिए एनर्जी कॉस्ट ज़्यादा होती है, और एनर्जी कॉस्ट ज़्यादा होती है जल्दी थक भी जाते हैं, और हमारा वॉकिंग स्पीड भी उनका हमारी ओल्ड एज पीपल का ज़्यादा होता है। तो जो भी साथ में हो कभी ये ना कहें दादा दादी जल्दी चलो या मम्मी पापा जल्दी चलो, ये एक नॉर्मल हमारी फिजियोलॉजी है। सो बेस हम क्या करेक्ट कर सकते हैं, वी नीड टू करेक्ट देयर वॉकिंग पैटर्न्स, उनको फ्रीली वॉक करने दें, उनको थोड़ा सा क्यू करें, देखो आप ये थोड़ा गलत चल रहे हैं, और ऑलवेज रिमेंबर कि जब भी आप वॉक करें कि आपका जो हील्स जो है वो पहले टच हो, देन टोस। Then we also have a cardiopulmonary changes, like हमारा cardiac reserve decrease हो जाता है, contractile function and heart rate जो है decrease हो जाते हैं, इसीलिए हमारी response जो होता है exercise के लिए वो भी decrease हो जाता है। Usually हम लोग जब भी OPD में patients देखते हैं ना तो उनके जो मतलब like बच्चे होते हैं या उनके साथ redundant होते हैं वो यही काम complain करते हैं, ये पहले तो इतना चल लेते थे अब इतनी जल्दी थक जाते हैं। सो ये एक बहुत जरूरी है हर चीज को एक्सेप्ट करना, दैट इज द मेन थिंग वन नीड टू एक्सेप्ट कि हाँ अब ये चेंजेस आएंगे, बट ये नहीं कि अगर वो कम चल रहे हैं तो लेट हिम और हर बी कि चलो ठीक है 5 मिनट वॉक कर रहे हैं, एटलीस्ट कर तो रहे हैं, नॉट आइसोलेटेड बेड रिडन तो नहीं है, दैट इज द मेन थिंग। कभी भी किसी चीज के लिए अगर खाने में अगर एक एज के बाद हम खाना नहीं, हम पहले 5 रोटी खाते थे क्योंकि हमारी जो डिमांड थी वो ज्यादा थी तो इसलिए हमें सप्लाई भी अच्छी देनी पड़ी, लेकिन अब जो है हम लोग आफ्टर 60 तो हमारी जो जो फिजिकल डिमांड्स हैं वो भी कम हो जाती है, अगर हम अगर 2 रोटी खाएं वो भी इनफ है, तो उस चीज़ को 60 इयर्स के बाद का जो गोल्डन पीरियड होता है उसको पहले वाली एज से कभी भी कंपेयर ना करें। हो सकता है कभी कभी पल्मोनरी फंक्शंस कम हो जाते हैं जैसे बताया हमने कि यूजुअली मेल्स के अंदर, सो कोई नहीं, एक ब्रीदिंग एक्सरसाइजेज आप करें, ब्रीदिंग टेक्निक, एक नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग पैटर्न इंप्रूव करें, अपनी लंग्स की एक्सपेंशन बढ़ाएं, दैट्स इट। इतना इसमें टेंशन लेने की होते हैं, थोड़े टाइम सांस खुलता है, कोई भी इंसान अगर रोज सीढ़ियाँ नहीं चढ़ रहा हो सडनली सीढ़ी चढ़ेगा उसके लिए, क्योंकि उसका हार्ट और उसकी लंग्स उतने अडाप्टेड नहीं है, तो आपको धीरे धीरे उस चीज़ को अडाप्ट करना पड़ेगा। दीज आर द फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंजेस, ये हैं, ये नेचुरल चेंजेस हैं, आप इसको कुछ नहीं कर सकते। सो क्या है बेसिकली, आपको इसके लिए फिक्र नहीं करनी, इसकी जो रिस्पॉन्स देना है यू नीड टू फोकस ऑन दैट कि ठीक है 5 मिनट्स वॉक हो रही है, 10 मिनट्स वॉक हो रही है, इट्स ओके। ब्रीदिंग एक्सरसाइज 10 मिनट्स वॉक में भी अगर आप एक बार बैठ जाएं, डीप ब्रीदिंग करें, अनुलोम विनुलोम करें, कोई इश्यू नहीं है उसमें। देन वी हैव अ न्यूरोलॉजिकल चेंजेस, बिकॉज हमारी जो नर्व्स जो होती हैं उसके अंदर भी डीजनरेशन शुरू हो जाती है। यूजुअली पीपल हैव टेंडेंसी ऑफ ट्रेमर, एट्रोफी ऑफ इंट्रोशियाज जो कहते हैं आपकी खाल लटक रही है हमारी, ये सब डिमिनिश्ड मसल स्ट्रेंथ। यूजुअली क्या होता है लोअर लेम की मसल स्ट्रेंथ कम होने लग जाती है क्योंकि वो वेट बेयरिंग जॉइंट्स हैं और हमारी बॉडी का ज़्यादा, तो इट हैज़ टू वर्क, और उसके साथ साथ हमारी जो बोन मिनरल्स हैं वो कम हो रहे हैं, मसल स्पेस स्ट्रेंथ मतलब लोड ज़्यादा आ रहा है तो इसलिए वो थोड़ा डिमिनिश हो जाते हैं। धीरे धीरे आप देखोगे, आप कभी भी देखना अपने पेरेंट्स में या अपने ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स में अगर आप देखें जो भी अबव 60s के हैं उनकी ना मसल टाइटनेस शुरू हो जाती है क्योंकि एक हैबिट चलती है कि टोन जो है ना उनका रिस्पॉन्स जो है वो बहुत अलर्ट रहता है ऑल टाइम. आप देखोगे उनकी नेक भी जो जैसे हम हमारी जितनी फ्लेक्सिबल है पूरी मूव होगी, उनकी नेक भी साइड में भी मूव करने में बहुत प्रेशर लगेगा क्योंकि धीरे धीरे टोन, एक तो है साइकोलॉजिकल स्ट्रेस उसको काम करना पड़ेगा, टोन बढ़ रही है उसके साथ धीरे धीरे उनकी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एक्सरसाइजेस मतलब जो एक हो. और ये भी नहीं कि स्ट्रेंथनिंग फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी सारी एक्सरसाइज एक ही दिन में आप करें, कोई नहीं, अपना रूटीन बना लें. वीक में 3 डेज ये फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी करेंगे, 3 डेज हम स्ट्रेंथ करेंगे, एक दिन रेस्ट करेंगे. एंड जैसे डॉक्टर गौरव ने भी बताया कि 150 मिनट्स पर वीक, तो आप कितनी देर मतलब 10 से 15 मिनट आपको अपना नॉर्मली उसके अंदर निकालना है. देन अब मैं आपको सबसे ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ होगी एकोमोडेशन, जो भी आपके लिए अपने अगर आपको स्ट्रांग रहना है, ये आपके फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंजेस हैं जो होंगे बॉडी में, बट वी नीड टू एकोमोडेट फॉर दीज चेंजेस क्योंकि ये जो इफेक्ट्स होते हैं ना ये इरिवर्सिबल होते हैं. और इम्पॉर्टेंट ये है कि एजुकेशन ऑफ फैमिली एंड इवन द पेशेंट्स कि दे आर नॉट पेशेंट्स मतलब यूजुअली ओल्ड एज पीपल, ये एक नेचुरल एजिंग है, इसको समझना पड़ेगा. ठीक है नहीं खाया जा रहा, नहीं चला जा रहा, इट्स ओके, वी नीड टू एकोमोडेट कि ठीक है अभी मैं अगर 10-20-25 मिनट एक साथ लिख कर सुबह मॉर्निंग में 10 मिनट्स की हल्की वॉक कर लूँगी, शाम में 10 मिनट्स की, ठीक है इतने में हो गया. सो बिना उसको लिए हुए एक अपनी लाइफ स्टाइल को थोड़ा सा मॉडिफाई करना पड़ेगा एंड स्ट्रेस को इंक्रीज नहीं करना है इसके साथ. एक्सरसाइज इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्योंकि इस एज में ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस, ऑस्टियोपेनिया और फ्रैक्चर्स होने के चांसेस होते हैं. यूजुअली नॉट इम्पैक्ट एरोबिक एक्सरसाइजेस, यूजुअली लाइट, वेरी लाइट वेट बेयरिंग एरोबिक एक्सरसाइजेस इज मस्ट फॉर ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस. सो एक बॉट्स की थ्योरी थी, यूज इट और लॉस्ट इट, क्योंकि हमारी मसल्स जो होती है ना सबसे ज़्यादा जिसको कहते हैं ना काम चोर, एक वैसी चीज़ है. अगर आप 10 दिन उस मसल को यूज़ नहीं करेंगे वो अपनी जो पावर स्ट्रेंथ है वो लूज कर देगी. सो इट्स बेटर कि कीप इट फंक्शनली एक्टिव, जस्ट फंक्शनली एक्टिव. कुछ अभी आपको स्ट्रेस कुछ ऐसा तो नहीं है कि आपको अब रोज़ जो है इस एज के बाद आपको बहुत हैवी हैवी चीज़ें उठानी या कुछ बहुत ज़्यादा एक्सेसिव वर्क करना. सो जस्ट मेंटेन अ गुड ऑप्टिमम हेल्थ की फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी भी है और इतनी फंक्शनल स्ट्रेंथ भी है कि मैं अपना ये दिन भर का काम कर सकता हूँ बिना थके. थर्ड थिंग इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि स्ट्रेस भी कम रहना चाहिए और जहाँ पे इम्पेयरमेंट मस्कुलोस्केलेटल प्रॉब्लम्स आए तो ऑलवेज सीक मेडिकल हेल्प. और स्टेबलाइजेशन ऑफ लाइक इम्पेयरमेंट किसी भी चीज़ का लाइक स्टेबलाइजेशन होना बहुत ज़रूरी है. हार्ट रेट ज़्यादा हो रहा है आपका या आपको अपने डॉक्टर से एनुअल चेकअप्स, ये सब बहुत ज़रूरी हैं इस एज में. एनुअल चेकअप्स कराएं अपना, और ज़रूरी भी नहीं, बहुत सारे लोग ये सोचते हैं कि अगर हम कराएंगे तो हमें बार बार जाना पड़ेगा. एक बार आप अपना एक्सरसाइज प्रोटोकॉल ले लें, एक बार अपना अपना मेडिसिन का चार्ट ले लें कि हाँ ये 3 मंथ्स चलेंगे 4 मंथ्स चलेंगे, नहीं जाना रोज़ रोज़ क्योंकि नाउ डेज एवरी वन इज़ वर्किंग, उनको हॉस्पिटल ही लेके जाना एक चैलेंज रहता है कि अपने पेरेंट्स को या ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स को कैसे लेके जाएंगे क्योंकि सब बिजी हैं अपनी लाइफ में. सो इट्स ओके कि कंसल्ट वन टाइम डन, जो भी उनका टेक केयर कर रहे हैं, जो भी उनके साथ अटेंडेंट है उनसे कहें कि सीख लें समझ लें ताकि वो आगे घर पे कंटिन्यू करते रहें. इट्स बेस्ट कि एक बार मिलके कंसल्ट करके उनके लिए जो भी बेस्ट है, क्योंकि एवरीवन इज यूनिक तो सबके लिए एक यूनिक ही ट्रीटमेंट रहेगा, तो उसके लिए बेस्ट पॉसिबल है कि आप आए एक बार मिल लें, एक बार उनका चार्ट बनवा लें, एक्सरसाइज का या डाइट का भी एक बार चार्ट बनवा लें. Then you follow up for 3 months, 6 months, a year, और जो भी best possible way हो उसके लिए आप बात करें. Then major issues जो अभी तक follow up कर रहे हैं that is falls. Falls जो है 30% of old age people में है. Usually एक तो stairs अभी ज़्यादा जैसे जिनके घर पे हैं वो ध्यान से चढ़ें, bathroom में कुछ ऐसे slippery मतलब tiles वगैरह ना हो, वो सब चीज़ें बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट हैं जिसकी वजह से हम इसका रेशियो ये जो परसेंटेज है 30% वी कैन रिड्यूस. और ऑन जब भी फॉल होता है तो हिप फ्रैक्चर्स बहुत कॉमन हो जाते हैं क्योंकि यूजुअली इम्पैक्ट जो आता है जो फ्लोर से टच में आता है सरफेस से वो हमेशा हिप जॉइंट होता है एंड देन देयर नीड्स वी नीड अ आर्थ्रोस्कोपी फॉर द सेम. और वही एज ए फाइव सेट क्योंकि सबसे कॉन्टैक्ट में हिप आता है देन पेल्विस और फोर आर्म ऐसे कोनी पे गिर जाते हैं तो रिजल्ट इनके फ्रैक्चर्स बहुत कॉमन होते हैं. और रिमेंबर कि ओल्ड एज में रीजनरेशन पावर कम होती है तो माइंड पेन भी ज़्यादा हो, टाइम भी ज़्यादा लगे मतलब उसको ठीक होने में, और शायद समवन नीड्स लाइक सर्जरी फॉर द सेम. So it's always better to prevent it. So ultimately क्या होता है जब once one fall जो हर चीज की एक vicious cycle चलती है तो एक बार गिरे थोड़ा सा फिर एक fear आ जाता है old age में कि हाँ हम गिर सकते हैं हम अकेले नहीं जा रहे तो क्या होता है कि अभी बेड से उठ के वॉशरूम भी नहीं जा रहे कोई आ जाए उसके सामने जाएंगे तो इससे इमोबिलिटी भी बढ़ती है और जैसे आप यूरिन होल्ड कर रहे हैं तो उससे आपकी यूरिनरी उस पर इनकॉन्टिनेंस या कोई ऐसी प्रॉब्लम भी स्टार्ट हो सकती है एंड अल्टीमेटली लीड्स टू वीकनेस एंड आइसोलेशन ऑफ वन पर्सन. आइसोलेशन लीड्स टू डिप्रेशन फिर वो डिप्रेशन से मस्कुलोस्केलेटल आपकी जॉइंट्स पे बोन्स पे मसल्स पे इफेक्ट पड़ेगा. ये विशियस साइकिल चलती रहेगी तो इसलिए सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ है छोटी चीज़ों का ध्यान रखें बड़ी वाली चीज़ें अपने आप धीरे धीरे. अब स्ट्रेटजीज क्या क्या हैं जो हम रिस्क जितने भी फॉल रिस्क हैं उसको कैसे रिड्यूस कर सकें. सबसे पहले विजुअल एम्पावरमेंट अपना रिफ्लेक्शन चेकअप करवाएं अपने आई साइट के लिए ज़रूर जाएं. अगर किसी को कैटरैक्ट है तो कैटरैक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड होम सेफ्टी असेसमेंट कि छोटे छोटे रग्स जैसे उनके अगर हमारे वो घर में मदर फादर को इतना एरिया में मोबाइल रहना है तो उनके नीचे छोटे छोटे रग्स ना हो कि उससे ट्रिपल मतलब उनके साथ टकरा के वो फॉल कर जाए या कोई भी ऐसी हिंड्रेंस बीच में ना हो तो उनके लिए मोबिलिटी वाला एरिया जो है वो फ्री रहे. ऑडियो वेस्टिबुलर डिसफंक्शन अपना ईयर बैग्स क्लियर करवा लें ऑडियोलॉजिकल इवेल्यूएशन करवाएं हियरिंग एड्स जो भी यूज कर रहे हैं पहने क्योंकि हमेशा एक बात याद रखिए आई साइट विजुअल हियरिंग एंड प्रॉपर रिसेप्शन तीन ऐसी चीज़ है दैट कीप्स योर बैलेंस प्रॉपर. सो अगर आपका बैलेंस नहीं होगा तो ज़्यादा चांसेस हैं आपकी फॉल जाने के. And habitual exercises, I must told you, habitual exercises, simple exercise which you can do or like you can make your parents or grandfathers do at home. You just need to focus on two things. मतलब like आपको अपनी without movement of neck, आपको eye की movement करनी है. That leads to like आपकी brain के अंदर आपका एक stimulus पहुँचेगा and habitual exercises हम इसे बोलते हैं usually VOR, vestibular ocular reflexes exercises. So you can do it at home by using a two pants or just focus on your nails, thumb के nails पे ये आपने रखा अपने सामने थोड़ा सा दूर एंड जस्ट आई बॉल की मूवमेंट करके आपको दोनों थंब को ये सेम वे अप एंड डाउन साइडवेज दोनों साइड आप इजीली आराम से कर सकते हैं. देन स्ट्रेटजीज डिसफंक्शन जो है विटामिन B12 जैसे सर ने बताया फूड इनटेक लें सर्वाइकल स्पॉन्डलिसिस की आप वो करवाएं. बैलेंस एक्सरसाइजेज यूजुअली क्या होता है कि नैरो बेस इसके लिए आपको फैमिली मेम्बर्स की बहुत ज़रूरत है. आप अपने लिए एक छोटा सा मतलब एक नैरो बेस ऑफ सपोर्ट में स्टैंड करके आइज ओपन आइज क्लोज करें किसी जैसे अनस्टेबल सरफेस में 2 से 3 मिनट खड़े हुएं. ये थोड़ी सी बैलेंसेस एक्सरसाइजेस दैट यू आर चैलेंजिंग योर बॉडी your proprioceptive functions to like activate. So always during this time keep your keep one family member with you. Use appropriate walking aid. ये बहुत बड़ा वो है कि old age में आके ना लोग घबराते हैं कि यार मैं अगर ये लेने चलूँगा वो क्या कहेगा ये क्या कहेगा. If it is must तो ज़रूर है. ऊपर से करेक्टली साइज फुटवेयर विद अ फर्म सोल एक अच्छी सोल होनी चाहिए जिसमें हाइट रेज्ड हो इनर साइड पे वो बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है आपके लिए क्योंकि क्या होता है कि जब आप विद एजिंग थोड़ा सा हमारा फ्लैट फीट की तरफ भी जाता है वेट के साथ साथ. अगर हमारा प्रॉपर सोल होंगे और शू बिल्कुल सही होगा साइज तो जो शॉक एब्जॉर्प्शन है और वेट बियरिंग जॉइंट्स है ना वो नॉर्मली जो वेट लाइन्स हैं हमारी वो सही नॉर्मल उस पर फॉल करेंगे. मस्कुलोस्केलेटल डिसऑर्डर्स हो गए फुट डिसऑर्डर्स हो गए कोई भी की डायबिटिक वालों को अपनी बहुत ज़्यादा केयर करने की ज़रूरत है. एंड पोस्चरल हाइपोटेंशन कभी भी ना जल्दी में ओल्ड एज पीपल के लिए एक ये टिप है कि अगर आप लेट के एकदम उठें खड़े ना पहले उठ के बैठें 2 मिनट क्योंकि हमारी बॉडी को अडेप्ट करने में थोड़ा टाइम लगता है ब्लड सर्कुलेशन इंक्रीज होने के लिए एक नॉर्मल होने दीजिए. देन कॉमन इम्पेयरमेंट्स होती हैं हमारे पास अर्थराइटिस बहुत कॉमन है. आप यूजुअली कोशिश करें कि एक नॉर्मल होम रेजिमेंट बना लें कि एटलीस्ट आपकी फंक्शनल इम्पेयरमेंट में आ जाए और अगर ग्रेड 3 है या जो भी ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिस का है किसी का भी है तो टॉक टू द लाइक ऑर्थोपेडिक कंसल्टेंट कि क्या फ़ायदा कि इतना पेन लेके हमेशा जी रहे अपनी क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ क्यों खराब करना है. एक बार कॉन्टैक्ट करें, बात करें. फ्रैक्चर्स कॉमन, क्योंकि ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस ऑलवेज डू, मैं ये कहूँगी लाइट, जैसे खड़े हुए से और कुछ हाथ ऐसे रखा, हल्का सा लेग मूवमेंट्स करें, नेक मूवमेंट्स करें, मतलब थोड़ा सा लाइट एक्सरसाइज, ताकि आपकी बोन्स पे थोड़ा वेट जाता रहे. लाइट वेट वेयरिंग एरोबिक एक्सरसाइजेस यूजुअली फॉर ऑस्टियोपोरोटिक और ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस. TBI, ट्रॉमेटिक ब्रेन इंजरीज, मे बी ड्यू टू एक्सीडेंट लाइक फॉल्स, ट्रिप्स, BP, पार्किंसन डिजीज. मैंने बहुत सारे अपने OPD में पेशेंट देखे हैं, लोग कहते हैं कि इसका कोई इलाज नहीं है. ठीक है, इसका कोई इलाज नहीं है, बट उस डिजीज की प्रोग्रेशन को तो हम हॉल्ट कर सकते हैं, उनकी क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ तो इम्प्रूव कर सकते हैं, उनके लिए बैलेंस, जो उसके साथ सेकेंडरी कॉम्प्लिकेशंस आ रही हैं हम उसको तो ठीक कर सकते हैं. सो वी नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ ऑल दीज थिंग. विजुअल कोई भी इम्पेयरमेंट हो, प्लीज गो एंड चेक कर. हेयरिंग लॉस एंड न्यूरोपैथी, क्योंकि यूजुअली जो पेरिफेरल नर्व्स होती हैं वो इफेक्ट होती हैं, वाइब्रेटरी सेंस, टेम्परेचर, ये सब हमारा सेंस कम हो जाता है. सो गो फॉर एवरीथिंग, चेकअप्स मस्ट. अब होम सेफ्टी के लिए मैं सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट कहूँगी, जो एलिवेटेड टॉयलेट सीट्स हैं वो अपनी आजकल हर मार्केट में, हर रूम्स में अवेलेबल हैं. इवन द टॉयलेट सीट्स आर अवेलेबल फॉर जीरियाट्रिक पॉपुलेशन. सो गो मस्ट बाय फॉर योर पेरेंट्स, बाय फॉर योर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, क्योंकि हमेशा क्या होता है, फॉल्स यूजुअली वो उठ नहीं पाए. ग्रैब हैंडल्स, बार्स जो हैं वो नियर बाय ज़रूर लगाएं, सो दैट उनके पास एक फॉर्म सपोर्ट हो उठने के लिए. टाइल्स नहीं होने चाहिए कोई भी स्लिपरी वाले बाथरूम्स के अंदर. नो स्किट फ्लोर मैट्स कभी भी, जैसे वॉशरूम के बाहर हम यूजुअली मैट्स लगाते हैं, वो ध्यान रखें कि कभी भी ऐसा ना हो कि आपको एकदम टकराएं और वो गिर जाए. तो ये सारी चीज़ें होम सेफ्टी प्रोफाइल्स हैं दैट यू नीड टू. अच्छा, ये एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ हाइट डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम पटेला टू फ्लोर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, क्योंकि क्या होता है कभी हाइट बहुत ऊपर हो जाती है, लाइक आजकल सॉफ्ट वो आ रहे हैं इतने ऊंचे 10 inches के मैट्रेसेस और ये सब, वो उसकी वजह से क्या होता है, जब भी वो उठते हैं तो उनका पैर जो फुट होता है वो सरफेस पर टच नहीं होता, चांसेस क्या होते हैं ज़्यादातर स्लिप के या फॉल के. तो ऑलवेज अगर कुछ भी किसी के घर में ऐसा है कि बहुत नीचे दबा हुआ है, बहुत ऊपर है, तो उसको एडजस्ट करें मैट्रेस को, जहाँ पे भी वो बेड हाइट है ना उसको इस तरह से कि उनका पटेला जो है, जहाँ उनकी स्लीपिंग एरिया है वो पटेला टच हो जब भी वो खड़े, तो उतनी हाइट रखें ताकि अगर वो सोते सोते, क्योंकि यूजुअली नाइट में यूरिनेशन के लिए उनको जाना ही पड़ता है, तो उसके लिए एकदम रात में अंधेरे में और उनको जोर से आ रहा है तो उनको भाग के जाना पड़ा, तो उसके लिए आपको एडजस्टमेंट बहुत ज़रूरी है. और जो लो चेयर्स हैं, काउचेस हैं, उनको अगर इफ एक तो मस्कुलोस्केलेटल प्रॉब्लम है, हमारी बोन्स जो हैं वो वीक हैं, तो खड़े होने पे उनकी मसल्स पे और ओवरलोड होगा. तो ऑलवेज ऑप्टिमम हाइट की चेयर्स या सोफास, ये सब होने चाहिए. और कुछ ऐसा स्टिक या उनके पास कुछ की, अगर उनको कुछ ऑब्जेक्ट्स उठाना है तो उनके रीच के अंदर आए, या शेल्फ्स बहुत ऊपर ना हो, तो उनके लिए ये सारे आप थोड़ा सा आप खुद अपने घर के अंदर ये देखें और इनको थोड़ी चीज चेंज करें. थैंक यू. और एक बात किसी अच्छे उसने प्रोफेशनल टेनिस प्लेयर ने कही है, व्हाई आर पीपल अफ्रेड ऑफ गेटिंग ओल्डर, यू फील वाइजर, यू फील मोर मैच्योर, यू फील लाइक यू नो योर सेल्फ बेटर, यू वुड ट्रेड दैट फॉर सॉफ्टर स्किन, नॉट मी. सो हमेशा याद रखें, ठीक है इट्स अ नॉर्मल एजिंग प्रोसेस, ये है, ये फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंजेस हैं, अब इस चीज़ में हमें अडेप्ट करना है, हमें जो छोटी चीज़ें हैं, एक तो टेंशन नहीं लेनी. देखिए बहुत सारी हमारी जो सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ होती है ना बाय एज ऑफ 60, वो भी कम हो जाती हैं, क्योंकि हम पे बहुत ज़्यादा किसी की फिक्र या अभी कैसे चलना है, फाइनेंशियल इश्यूज, ये सब हमारे पे नहीं होते, उन लोगों पे नहीं होते जो 60 ईयर्स से अबव. तो ठीक है, वो जो न्यू सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ हैं, ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रंस की टेक केयर या अपने आप की टेक केयर ना, उसके अंदर एकोमोडेट होना बहुत ज़रूरी. थैंक यू सो मच. Now we have a question answer round.
Thank you.
So we have few questions with us. One of the questions is, what all things I can add in diet of my old age parents for reducing fatigue and muscle aches? So many things we have already discussed, but I'll just repeat them again. First of all, we should take lots of proteins and vitamin D. Vitamin D in food products is usually not available, and we don't have fortified vitamin D milk in our country. So what else we can do? If we can have a little bit of vitamin D is there, a little bit in mushrooms and vegetables and milk, you should take them. And eggs you can take. So eggs is a very good for fatigue and muscle ache. The main problem detection is very important. What is the cause? The deficiencies is a cause, but there can be because of the muscle weakness, or there might be some injury in some part of the body, on the ligament, in the tendon. So you should get yourself checked with the doctor once, and then you can start taking these vitamins. These will overall help. Calcium is there, and in calcium you have to take milk. Even if you are not, some people are in old age are not able to digest milk. So then they can take curd, they can take lassi, chhach. So any product, paneer is also very good. So that will also lead to strong muscles and strong bones, and fatigue and muscle aches can be. And there are a lot of deficiency of minerals and minerals. So those like we have magnesium, it's deficient. So that can also cause a lot of fatigue. Anybody would like to add something?
As rightly said, minerals, the most common reason for fatigue is sodium and potassium deficiency, also magnesium and selenium deficiency. These are fancy terms, but these are essentially minerals, which are available in fruits, available in vegetables. So a normal Indian diet is actually rich in minerals. What we normally avoid is proteins. As Dr. Yashika rightly said, is that you should have dietary proteins. We think that proteins digest not digest, we don't give them. ठीक है, बट सिंपल चीज जैसे एग वाइट हो गया, ठीक है, दैट्स वेरी रिच इन प्रोटीन्स, वेरी इजी डाइजेस्टेबल, आप ये दीजिए. एंड जो आपका अगर आपको लग रहा है कि मिनरल्स की कमी हो रही है, तो सिंपल एक नींबू पानी, राइट, दैट हैज विटामिन सी. अगर आप रॉक सॉल्ट डालेंगे, बिकम्स रिच इन पोटेशियम, रिच इन सोडियम. अगर आप दिन में एक बार पिला रहे हैं, तो दैट हेल्प्स अ लॉट.
सेम वे साइकोलॉजिकल हेल्थ इज इम्पोर्टेंट, क्योंकि समटाइम्स कुछ जैसे किसी चीज की स्ट्रेस या टेंशन कैन ऑल्सो कॉज अ मसल पेन, एंड लाइक पीपल फील लेथार्जिक आफ्टर दैट. सो यू नीड टू टेक केयर, यू नीड टू इन्वॉल्व, लाइक यू नीड टू हैव इवन अ गुड स्पिरिचुअल माइंड ऑल्सो. लाइक एवरीथिंग शुड बी बैलेंस, डाइट, फिजिकल एक्टिविटी, एंड योर लाइक इमोशनल वेलबींग. सो दीज थ्री कॉम्पोनेंट शुड आर इंटरकनेक्टेड विद ईच अदर. If there is like psychological stress, so khana bhi wo log acche se nahi khate. So basically everything is connected. So one must be take care of food, physical activity, and the emotional well-being of the patient or old age people.
Okay, thank you. You can take the next question.
What do about supplements?
What should we do about sleeplessness in old age?
Okay. So usually sleeplessness happens in old age because ki unki physical jo demand hai wo slower down ho jati hai. So uske liye we have like even in some apps, some like YouTube also, we have like alpha wave binaural music. So before sleeping, just ask them to listen those music for 5 to 10 minutes. These are just beats for us. So it releases the hormones in our bodies. Relaxation hormone, this serotonin, like endorphin, also releases in our body, and it induces the sleep cycle. With this, some kind of postures also induces the sleep, like lying down in supine position and just like cross touching your foot in this way, and just move your knee up and down for 4 to 5 times, and then relax in that same position for 3 to 4 minutes. And it will help you to induce your sleep as well.
Like a butterfly position.
Yeah.
One more thing regarding sleeplessness is that it is actually seen in all ages, but more in old ages, is the use of exposure to screens. Suppose if you are watching TV, right, and suddenly you close your TV and think that I'll go to sleep, then that normally doesn't happen. Right? Or you check your cell phone, right? The moment the LED goes on, right, your mind gets activated. So to sleep, you have to avoid any sensory input. So no hearing, no seeing something, right? The moment you see a bright screen, your mind gets activated as if you are, it goes in alert mode.
So of course you won't be able to sleep immediately after that. So that is something I've seen many elderly, and I simply ask them, right, do you check your WhatsApp before sleeping? And believe me, majority of time the answer is yes, I do check my WhatsApp before sleeping, right? And I say, okay, that is a cause why you're not able to sleep.
So I would just like to add, like, what we have discussed is that we should all have a sleep curriculum or a practice at night before going to the sleep. So this is all included in that. Like when, what time you have to go to sleep before that, 10-15 minutes before, wash your face, wash your legs, change your clothes, get into a comfortable attire. You can even put on a soft music and a light, small dim light in elderly. We will all suggest, all of us I think will agree, that there should be a light in the room. The toilet doors should not be closed, and the comfortable footwear will be there, should be there, because they should not fall. So because most of the elderly in my house also, they want the lights should be totally off. But even if not in the room, in the bathroom, some light should be open. So, and before sleeping, like, you are listening to the music, you can take a book. If you are not able to sleep, you read a book. And most of the time, what I have seen, most of the people have some bowel issues. That is the reason they are not able to sleep. So please correct your bowel issues and exercise a little bit. That will help you to induce sleep. I think the last question is especially for Dr. Gaurav only.
Right, coming to whether knee replacement is indicated after 85 years of age, I'll just put it in perspective. A lot of studies about undergoing knee replacement in elderly that's more than 80 years old, a study says that you have a higher chance of complications after 80 years of age. Irrespective of the age, what basically is determined, what determines whether you can undergo knee replacement or not is how physically active you are. See, if I'm a 75-year-old, I'm moribund, I have kidney problems, I am diabetic, I am grossly obese, then yes, knee replacement is not a surgery for me. But if I'm a very fit and active 85-year-old who is not having any medical problem or just simple BP, etc., but I'm having pain in my knee and previously also I was walking kilometers and kilometers, then yes, I will benefit from knee replacement. What literature currently says is that in case you are 80 years and above and you are undergoing knee replacement, then you should undergo one knee replacement at a time, right? So normally we replace both the knees at the same time, but there's a very clear-cut literature, a guideline from NICE, that's a National Institute of Clinical Excellence in England, which clearly mentioned that you have to replace knees one by one after, once you have a patient who is more than 80 years old, right? So if you're asking, can I ask my parents to have their knee replaced, they are 85 years old, then I'll simply answer that depends upon their fitness. If they are fit, if they are able to do their household chores themselves, if they are independent, then yes, you can go ahead with knee replacement, but it will be one knee at a time. If they are frail, if they have a lot of medical problems, right, if besides knee, they also have issues in their back, issues with their heart, issues with their lungs, then we should avoid having knee replaced.
I would like to ask Dr. Gaurav one thing, because many of the my patients also ask me this question. After knee replacement, what is the way, how can they get back to the normal life, and how much days they will be starting to walk, and how much days they will be can walk much better, and what is the, because of the old, because many old people are very scared whether they should go for it or not go for it.
I mean, that fear is always there, and yeah. It takes us hours and hours of counseling, and even the relatives, they do counsel their parents or their relatives a lot that, okay, right, now's the time, you've been eating painkillers for so long, right, kindly get the knee replaced, but many people are afraid. So the answer is that you have to understand it is a major surgery, right? It's not something which you are doing in a matter of minutes, and right, it's an invasive procedure. It is a major surgery. It has its own recovery times. If you've been having knees which have been deformed bad for 15 years, then do not expect you to be all right in a matter of few days. Right? After knee replacement, you are allowed to walk. That's the beauty of it. You can put full weight on it and you can walk on it. Right? Normally we allow walking after
the next day.
Right? But there's a DASH protocol now which says that you start walking immediately after the surgery. Well, I mean, the moment the effect of spinal dysesia wears off, 4 hours, and so you are walking right on the day of the surgery. Right? After 4 to 5 hours of surgery. So you can be awake, but yes, you will need walker. Right? To replace the knee, we have to go through the main mother muscle of the knee, which is your quadriceps, that is extensor muscles. So that muscle takes time to recover. Right? So initially you will be walking only with the help of walker. Right? Yes, you will have some difficulties, but we do have a very good team of physiotherapists to help you go through that recovery period. And we expect you to get rid of walker in 6 weeks of time. Some people do get rid of walker much earlier, in 3 to 4 weeks. Some people take a bit longer, right? What is more important is your muscle strength. The stronger the muscles are, the merrier it is, right? If you are having very strong muscles, then you will recover very fast after knee replacement. That is what, that's the role of preoperative physiotherapy, preoperative exercises. Right? If you are somebody who is having deformed knees, very weak muscles, then probably knee replacement would reap its benefits in some, say, 6 to 8 months. On an average, it's 3 months. That is the time which we say that majority of people, they become all right after knee replacement. One thing you have to understand is knee replacement is a very fruitful procedure, but it brings down your pain from a score of 10 out of 10 to say 2 out of 10 or 1 out of 10. You do feel a bit of aches and slight heaviness in your knee, right? Sometimes your knee might pain, but majority of people are happy with it, right?
So, and physiotherapy should be continued for how long?
For at least 1 month.
And if the people have weak muscles, they will?
Only with the teacher or exercise. The thing, the moment, usually patient for ki hamari usne related ne karai thi wo surgery, uska 10 din mein theek ho gaya, 15 din mein. Matlab har kisi ki body, muscle strength, bone density alag hoti hai. So sabse important cheez hai ki ek kisi bhi patient ko apne mind se ye cheez nikalna bahut zaruri hai ki uski itni jaldi theek ho gayi ya uska itna matlab pain nahi hua. Ye bahut sare log yahi questions leke aate hain ki uska to maybe usne karaya tha 10 din mein theek ho gaya chal paaye. तो हर किसी की बॉडी मसल मास देखिए, जो बेस्ट है 3 months का प्रोटोकॉल एक टाइम लिमिट देते हैं कि उसके अंदर बेटर होने के चांसेस बहुत अच्छे
हैं. एंड आफ्टर नी सर्जरी व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स दे कैन नॉट डू फॉर एवर इन लाइफ.
आई मीन
स्क्वाटिंग एंड ऑल दैट,
देयर इज नो करंट डिक्टम एज दैट व्हाट यू कैन नॉट डू, राइट? यू हैव टू जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द नी रिप्लेसमेंट और द नी इम्प्लांट. इट्स जस्ट लाइक अ कार, राइट? इट्स मेड ऑफ मशीन, इट्स मेड ऑफ स्टील एंड प्लास्टिक. सो आई मीन it the life of my car depends on the way I'm driving. Suppose if I drive very fast, sudden brakes, fast, sudden brakes, then my car will wear off in 6 to 7 years. But if I take care of that car, right, if I'm not driving it in a rash manner, then my car would easily last 15 years, 20 years. The same thing happens with the knee. If you squat, squatting is possible, right, even after knee replacement. And the current implants are very well designed to allow you to squat. So squatting is possible, but the moment you squat, you're putting a lot of load on that artificial knee. So all the forces that made your natural knee undergo wear and tear, those forces will also cause your artificial knees to undergo wear and tear. So the more you squat, and every time you squat and you're getting up, right, you're placing a lot of load on that knee. So yes, your knee would wear and tear much earlier than if you would have not been squatting. So that is why we simply advise them that if you can avoid squatting, then that's very good. But if you have to squat, suppose आप पूजा में गए हैं, ठीक है, बैठना पड़ रहा है नीचे, ठीक है, आप एक बार बैठ सकते हैं, but रोज आपको नहीं बैठना है, आपको अपना टॉयलेट चेंज करना पड़ेगा. अगर घर में इंडियन कमोड है, you have to use western commode, because आपका डेली स्क्वाटिंग वाला जो रिक्वायरमेंट है वो कम हो जाएगा. सो ये चीज होती है. अब रनिंग के ऊपर आते हैं, हमारे पास ऑनेस्टली स्पीकिंग ऐसे लोग आते हैं जो कि क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं दैट आई लव रनिंग एंड आई वॉन्ट टू गो बैक टू माई पैशन ऑफ रनिंग. The answer is yes, you can run on knee replacement. But again, the moment you run, you're putting a lot of load on those knees. Right? So, we say that this wear and tear will be a little faster, but it's not going to happen. SME patients are joking who have actually gone on trekking trips and they have come back from areas like Thrayund and other beautiful places, right, after having their knee replaced.
They were not able to do it for a very long time.
Yes,
so
exactly. They were missing it. Log Amarnath ki yatra karke aate hain.
One question is there. My mother in-law is diabetic and her kidney is also just 40% working. She is 70 and overweight. Can you suggest some diet plan for her? Like, we can see that there are two conditions. The patient has diabetes and then she has kidney problems. So with diabetes, obviously, she needs a lot of to take care of her diabetes and she should take a diabetic diet. And that also, we have not mentioned whether she's on medication or on insulin. If she's on insulin, then she needs medication along with the diet chart and diabetic diet along with kidney disease. I think she should meet a dietitian to take a proper diet chart. And if her diabetes is not, and she's overweight, she has to lose weight to get corrected her diabetes, because ultimately, even if you are overweight and you are taking proper care of your diet, but you are not able to lose weight, there is no use, and your diabetes will not get corrected. Diabetes can be cured, everybody should understand, if you lose weight. If we go back to our BMI, you are almost, your diabetes is 80 to 90% cured. It is not a disease which will stay with you, but it may be at an age of 70, it will be very difficult for us to treat her for that and ask her to change her dietary habit. But if she is motivated enough, you can do. And with the kidney, I think high protein diet cannot be given if she uric acid is high, and kidney related all that we should avoid.
Kidney is the main place where your blood gets filtered. So salt is something which your kidney has to handle a lot. So if you are actually a salt lover, then that is something which you have to stop. Right? It is said that you should not eat added salt. So doctor, sabji mein jitna namak hota hai, har sabji ke andar ek fixed amount of namak hota hai. That should be enough, right? If you are having kidney problems, you should not put added salt into it. That is important, right? You have to avoid foods which are, which suddenly release a lot of salt in their body. Like banana is one food which has a lot of potassium, right? And it can lead to potassium overload. So yes, that is something. But my recommendation, my genuine advice for you is that if she is having so much problems, then she should have a proper diet plan charted out. And for that, a dietitian would be a better person.
Right? One thing I would like to add on this thing, lots of my old patients, and they have hypertension, they are taking Sendha Namak. Please, Sendha Namak is very rich in potassium. They have stopped taking normal salt and their potassium is increasing. Please stop doing, get rid of that habit. Take normal salt in less amount. If you want to have something on salad, you can put a Sendha Namak on that. But don't make Sendha Namak your staple diet. I think many of the patients are doing this wrongly, so we should avoid doing that. One last question I think we can take if we have time. Yeah, one last question is from my side to Dr. Gaurav only. I have lots of patients who have weak bones after the age of 60. And the one thing I would like to know, for them, the bone densitometry, when they should be done, and what all medication, like I usually give calcium and vitamin D. Phosphates also I give, but there are some injectables are required in phosphates sometimes when they are very low. So how to detect it, and when they should come for bone densitometry, and when that patient should come to you directly for her treatment?
So basically, they say that prevention is better than cure. Getting bone densitometry is more a modality of prevention. Now, the guideline says that in women, the moment you have your menopause, right, you should get your bone density tested. Not during the time you are having your menopause, once you are over with that, right? So that is mostly like 50, 51 years old, right? Get your bone density done. In men, the guideline says 65 years. So 65 years is the age where men should have their bone density tested, right? And so that is prevention. Okay, but if you are having recurrent fractures, right? Some countries like Singapore, for every patient who ends up having a hip fracture, they will test the bone density. So they may be mandatory, right? So it depends on hospital to hospital, on countries to countries, right? So, but prevention, for the purpose of prevention, get your bone density checked. When you are 50, 51 years old, if you are a woman, the moment you have your menopause, in case you have a premature menopause, you can even get a bone density check before that. Right? In men, it's 65 years.
Any family history in which you should get your bone densitometry early then?
Yes. It's not just bone densitometry, then it is a proper bone screening procedure. There are conditions, rare conditions like osteogenesis imperfecta, where you end up having recurrent fractures. In case you are having repeated fractures and fractures by trivial trauma, like you sustained a jerk, right, and you just put your hand on the table and you broke your wrist. So that's a trivial trauma, right? You didn't fall actually. So in case you are having systemic fractures because of such trivial trauma, then you have to get your bone density checked. Right? There are a lot of genetic conditions where your bone density will be low. But then the incidence of that is so rare. So that that's why these guidelines say that there's an age parameter. We have to remember the most common cause of osteoporosis is actually menopause, which is a physiological process, and then next most common is senile, that is aging. It's again a physiological process. So these both causes are the most common cause of osteoporosis. Yes, if you're having recurrent fractures, if you have family history of recurrent fractures, mom or dad had recurrent fractures, or then you can get your bone density checked the moment you become skeletally mature. That means by age of 20, 21 years, if you have very strong family history, only that time.
Thank you. Dr. Gaurav, what is your take on taking calcium regularly after menopause? Because many of my patients say, my doctor has said that I will have kidney stones if I take calcium. But my take is that they should take calcium because diet will not supplement with them with the adequate amount. So,
well, the reason for having stones, if you take rich calcium, is vitamin D deficiency. So what happens is that if you are rich in vitamin D, then the moment you take a calcium, it will be absorbed from your stomach. That's the role of vitamin D, and vitamin D will simply take the calcium and put it in the bone. Right. Conversely, if you are deficient in vitamin D, right, you will take calcium. Most of it will won't be absorbed and will pass in your feces. Some that is absorbed will not be able to go into your bone because you're not having vitamin D. So what happens is this calcium is then passed via your kidneys in the urine. So when you have high concentration of calcium in the urine, plus if you are dehydrated, if you do not have a habit of drinking a lot of water, then this calcium gets concentrated and you form stones. So culprit is not a calcium tablet, right? Culprit is the fact that you are deficient in vitamin D. So that's why all the screening procedures now, all the health checks now, they insist on getting your vitamin D and vitamin B12 check. That's the role.
So the old ladies who are most menopausal, they should take calcium regularly?
Yes, for calcium the dictum is a 2 months, 1 month rule. That means you don't have to take calcium indefinitely, regularly. Take it for 2 months, leave for 1 month. Then take it for 2 months, leave for 1 month. But yes, calcium you have to take it if your diet is not rich in calcium.
Well, lots of patients are like we remember one of the patients who was taking phosphates for a long time and you told me that she will have brittle bones.
Right.
So I think patients who are at home and taking the same medication for last 1 to 2 years, they should visit doctor and just update their prescription whether they should keep on taking them or not.
The problem in treating osteoporosis is that all the medications which we have in the market for treating osteoporosis, you cannot take them indefinitely. Bisphosphonates, what Dr. Yachika is talking about, are those tablets which you are taking once in a week or once in a month, like if your doctor advises you so. The moment you take them for a duration more than 2 years, they can actually end up damaging your bone. Bone construction and destruction is something which keeps on happening. And that is not, bone destruction is not bad. That is important for remodeling, right? So once a new bone is formed, right, with time this bone will age, and then what body does is the body destroys that aged bone and then deposits new bone in that. What these tablets, all these medicines for osteoporosis, they do is they remove the body's ability to destroy that bone. So there's a mechanisms in our body which are responsible for destroying those bones. Now what happens is that when you remove that mechanism, these medicines will suppress the bone destruction mechanism, then the bone which was formed, say 5 years ago, 6 years ago, now becomes aged and will soon crumple under stress. So you end up actually having fragility fractures. And the problem with these fractures are very nasty to treat, very difficult to treat. They have higher chances of not uniting, despite the fact you might operate on them, you might put bone grafts. So that is why we advise all our patients who take bisphosphonates to not take them more than 2 years. Now coming to injection thing, you would have heard about injection, that my doctors advised me injections which I had to inject myself to increase my bone density. Those injections are expensive, they cost me around 6,000-7,000 rupees a month, right? Again the same thing with that, right? Those injections are teriparatide injections, they are again for bones, to increase the bone density. But again, you cannot take them for more than 2 years because there are studies that continuous administration of teriparatide can lead to a kind of bone cancer. So, but then there are theoretical studies. Till now, there has been no case report of somebody having bone cancer because of teriparatide administration on a long basis. But there are a lot of theoretical reports about that. So that is why we simply ask you to not take them. Now, another thing you would have heard is nasal sprays. Right, so a lot of people advise nasal spray to take, and for long term, again the limit for a nasal spray is around 6 to 8 months. You cannot take it for more than 6 to 8 months because it decreases the blood supply of your nose. So in the nose you have a bridge called as nasal septum. So continuous take of calcitonin nasal spray can actually lead to these septal perforations. So again, we you not to take it for more than 6 to 8 months. So. And those who are having very severe osteoporosis, they are advised anabolic steroids, which are returning. So anaplasia was first introduced for treatment of osteoporosis. They initially became very popular, then they had this problems with the heart. So, but we do give them, and for very elderly patients, they actually are much safer than bisphosphonates and teriparatide injections, and they are much cheaper than either of these. Right, but again, you cannot give them. You cannot give more than 10 injections in a span of around 14 to 18 weeks. So all these medicines, they have their own limits, right? They are not free of side effects. That is why prevention is better than cure. That is why exercise, right? That is why take a good diet, exercise properly. So depend on your daughter-in-law or sons to do things, right? Just get a have a habit of doing your things yourself. That is very important to have healthy bones and good bones.
Thank you, Dr. Gaurav. You have enlightened me. I can picturize everything right. Very well. Afia, just we'll end with the last question. Afia, can you just tell the old people which exercises they can do at home of and specify the bone which is important in that area?
Actually, the thing is, usually for old age people, we don't need to like have a high impact aerobic exercises or strength training. We just want our old age people to be healthy, functionally independent. We need to be functionally independent. For this, you can go for a light walk for 10 minutes in morning, 10 minutes in. Just a light walk, taking care of your gait pattern. Because usually, if the gait pattern altered in old age, so one should take care of the gait pattern, walking straight with a proper base of support and with a proper swinging of arms. And one should take care, because with aging, the lower lower body muscle strength decreases because of the bone mineral loss and even over stress on the muscles, on the lower layer muscles. So one need to take care of doing light exercises. If one has hypertension problem, no one will go for isometric exercise for lower limb, because it increases the pressure on the heart. So one should take care for that, just light movement exercises, including the large muscle group. If one can do mini squatting or sitting and taking the knee up to the chest, including all the large major muscle group, you can make the every joint mobile, flexible, and then you can have a strength which is for your functional movement or day-to-day activity, that you don't feel any fatigue or overstress on the muscles.
Thank you, everyone.